Hi everyone, welcome back to BankExamsToday.com, and this is our 8th video lesson in the 5 minutes vocabulary. Again, we are going to learn 5 new words, their synonyms and their antonyms along with the examples in the sentences, right? So before starting this video, I advise you to use all the words in sentences, and when you have made your sentences, drop them in the comment section so that I can check your sentences and provide you a feedback. The PDF will be available in the description board. You can download the PDF for future reference. Okay, so without wasting any minute, let's start the very first word, which is tumultuous. Tumultuous means something that has a very loud noise, or there is confusion everywhere, chaos, and nothing is certain. For example, when there are riots in the city, in any city, if you have witnessed the riots, you see one thing, that everything is very loud, people shouting, there are sirens, gunshots, all the noise is very loud, then everything is in confusion, nothing is confirmed from where the police will come, where will the rioters or the people will go, what could be the strategy for the army. So everything is uncertain. So this kind of situation is called tumultuous, when nothing is fixed and there is violence all around. Okay, the synonyms are deafening. Deafening, when something is very loud and you cannot hear anything. Thunderous, stormy, turbulent, violent, and volatile. Volatile, something that is not fixed. Antonyms are peaceful, eventful, uneventful, orderly, calm, and soft. So everything is very calm, very soft, nothing is going wrong there. Okay, the example is, after the tumultuous event of 1990, it means in the 1990, the country faced violence, faced turbulence, so Europe was completely transformed. The second word is formidable. Formidable is a feature of someone that inspires fear in somebody. For example, there is a teacher in your class who is very strict. So whenever you see that teacher, you feel a sense of fear in you. That personality or that characteristic of the person is called formidable. That inspires fear or respect through being impressively large or powerful, because teachers have the power. Sometimes we see a politician, a don, all these people having the ability to inspire people, fear in the people, that is called formidable. The synonyms are frightening, terrifying, disturbing, or dreadful. You can see formidable. See how large is the giant, and people are running here and there. So this characteristic of scaring people is called formidable. Antonyms are feeble. Feeble means weak, friendly, nice, harmless, or unthreatening. Example, she is a formidable figure who commands a great deal of respect. It means the lady or the person has a formidable figure. She inspires fear, and that is why people respect her out of fear. Third word is mar. M-A-R, mar. The last R in the English language is not pronounced, so it is just mar. So you have to learn the pronunciation as well. It is mar. So mar means to impair the quality or appearance of. You just make something ugly or spoil all the qualities a thing or a person has. For example, there is a fight between two people and one person gets so many scars on the face because his face was mutilated, right? So his face is not clearly distinguished because he has so many scars on the face and all the features are no more. If the person has a very beautiful face and it is spoiled now, that is marred. The synonyms are spoil, ruin, blemish, scar, mutilate, and deface. Antonyms are create, because when you spoil something, the antonym should be you create something. Adorn means to make something more beautiful. Here you make something ugly, but the antonym will be adorn. Embellish, to add minute details in something to make it more beautiful, repair or mend. Example: violence by the party activists has marred the election process. It means the election process has been spoiled by the violence. Okay, the fourth word is reconciliation. Reconciliation means you become friends again. For instance, you had a fight with your best friends, and after 2 or 3 months of being angry at each other, you sort out your misunderstandings and you become friends again. That process is called reconciliation, to restore your friendly relationships. Okay, the synonyms are reunion, you unite again, resolution, settlement, rectification or amity. The antonyms are estrangement, reconcile, you come close again, and estrangement means you become strangers, alienation, feud, incompatibility, because you don't know, you two are no longer compatible. So that is incompatibility. Example: if the reconciliation between the two Indian tribes take place, it means the two Indian tribes sort out their misunderstandings and they settle down, there will be finally peace in the area. The last word is covert. Covert, we have done a word which is overt. Overt means something which is very clear or transparent. So covert is the opposite of that word. Covert means not openly acknowledged or displayed, or something that is done in a secretive manner, that is covert or secret. Like this girl is hiding, she is not properly displayed, she tries to conceal herself, or she is trying to be secretive. So the synonyms are secret, furtive, clandestine and stealthy. Antonyms are open, public, overt, unconcealed or candid, because you have nothing to hide, but here you are hiding, so you are being covert. So if you want to remember this word, just take the word cover. Cover means you are hiding something, you don't want it to be displayed. So covert, adding extra T, means you are again being secretive, you don't want people to see your money, your things, anything. Okay, so example is, as an investigator, John often uses covert surveillance methods. Covert surveillance method just means the methods of surveillance which are secretive, to follow his suspects without being seen, right? So this is all about the five words of today. What you need to do: like the video, share it with your friends, and if you haven't subscribed, just click on the subscribe button so that you can get to see all the videos and you will get the notification whenever we upload a new video. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any doubt or query regarding Bank Exams Today's courses, video lessons or anything, just drop it on insta@bankexamstoday.com. I'll see you tomorrow. Till then, keep practicing and work hard.